Namaste viewers, hello and welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In this video, we will see the story of Pancha Pandavas journey towards the Swarga, Swargarohana or heaven. The story goes like this. After the great war of the Mahabharata, peace returned to normalcy, everything was normal. It returned back in the kingdom, everything was normal. Time passed on like this. And the Pandavas, the heroic brothers who had fought so bravely, they began to feel that their life's mission was complete. Following Vyasa's advice, all these five men renounced their kingdom and began their final journey towards liberation. Now, before leaving, King Yudhishthira did all that was to be done, crowned Parikshit, the grandson of Arjuna, as the new king of Hastinapur. Then Vajra, a prince of the Yadava dynasty, was made king of another portion of this thing. Then the Pandavas, Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakula, Sahadeva and their beloved wife Draupadi left the comforts of the palace and then they started their journey towards Himalayas. Before which they travelled east, west, south and then they moved towards the north. Now a loyal dog, a very loyal dog joined them at the start of their journey itself. It was silently walking beside them. So as they travelled across all parts of India, they came upon many sacred places, rivers, forests, the site of Dwaraka, their cousins Krishna's city, now submerged under water. Filled with sorrow, they were feeling very sorrowful. It reminded them of the impermanence of life. So, undeterred, they continued towards the towering peaks of the Himalayas. So, all these five people are, after completing all their journey in this vast land, you know, they are moving towards the northern portion, northern side of the Himalayas, north towards Himalayas. Of course, the journey was very tough. The mountains were very steep. The climate was very, very cool, very cold. So as they were moving, Draupadi was the first to stumble and fall. She had no strength. She could not move further. She just fell there and then she remained there. Now she has fallen. Bhima, the strongest of the brothers, you know, he turns towards Yudhishthira and asked, so we all wanted, we have tried to live in the best way. But why did this Draupadi fall here? Why she could not continue this journey? Why could she not? Yudhishthira, who was known for his wisdom, who was known for his understanding of the Dharma in its true sense, replied, Draupadi, she loved us all equally. But Draupadi had a special affection for Arjuna. Her partiality was her weakness and she must bear the consequences. With heavy hearts, the remaining Pandavas pressed on and leaving Draupadi behind. They left the Draupadi behind there. So they did whatever they wanted to do for this mortal remains of Draupadi and they moved on. The next is Sahadeva. False. Just a little after this journey, the youngest brother Sahadeva also fell to the ground. So all these five were together in anything, you know, they were together. So Bhima, again, you know, he was filled with great grief. We are all together, but why this? He questioned again, why did our wise brother fall? He was the wisest among all. Yudhishthira again sighed and answered, Sahadeva was indeed wise, but he was also proud of his wisdom. He believed that no one was equal to him in knowledge. His pride has brought him to this end. So one should not be proud too much. That was the lesson he did not learn. Therefore, he said Sahadeva had fallen. So now the remaining people, you know, they just perform all the rites for Sahadeva and then move on. Next, Nakula falls. He was unmatched for handsomeness. He was looking so good, so beautiful, so well-mannered. He also fell. Then again, Bhima asked what was the fault of Nakula. Yudhishthira explained, Nakula too suffered from pride. He believed that he was the most handsome man in the world. Vanity is vice, even in those who are otherwise virtuous. So, Yudhishthira explained, Nakula too fell. So now, Arjuna, Bhima, and then Yudhishthira, they perform all the rites that are required to be done to Nakula, and then they move on. As they move on, you see Arjuna also, the greatest archer, the greatest, most skilled warrior, who was next to Sri Krishna, was best friend of Sri Krishna, he also falls down. And Bhima was, he cried very loud. He said, I couldn't believe such a great, such a mighty, such a honored brother falls. He was the hero of the Mahabharata. He had fallen. Yudhishthira again replied, Arjuna was indeed a hero, but he too was consumed by pride. He believed that no one else was equal to him in the archery skills. His arrogance has led to his downfall, he says. Now, they had to move on. They moved on like this. Bhima also now falls. The last brother, Bhima, and the loyal duck, Bhima Yudhishthira, and the loyal dog, you know, they all the three continue, but however, the mighty Bhima soon grew tired and collapsed. He was totally breathless. And as breathless, you know, he asked Yudhishthira, brother, why must I too fall? What was my fault? What did I do? Yudhishthira answered firmly, Bhima, you were strong and powerful, but you often indulge in gluttony. You ate more than what you needed without thinking of other sanghas. So that is why you boasted of your strength also. It is for this that you have fallen. Now, everybody have fallen. Only Yudhishthira and the dog are left. Now, Yudhishthira was alone, left alone with the dog. He continued his journey. He was going up to Mount Meru, determined to reach the gates of heaven. He was moving on. Suddenly, Indra, the king of gods, appeared before him in his ratha, celestial chariot. You know, he comes there. He invites Yudhishthira, come on to this, chariot. I will take you. This Vimana, Pushpaka Vimana, we will carry you. Come. Now, Yudhishthira, you politely refused. I can't go to heaven without my brothers. And Draupadi, he said, see, I have to be there with all the five, you know, I have to be there, otherwise I will not go. Now Indra explained that his brothers and Draupadi were already in heaven. They were cleaned of their sins through their deaths, because they died, you know, all their sins were removed. So now Yudhishthira then asked, is that so? Then okay, yes, they have all gone, it's okay. Then if I have to come, let this dog also come with me. He has been my companion throughout this journey. Indra said nothing to him. No. So only humans can come there. Dog cannot enter heaven, he said. Then Yudhishthira said nothing to him. He was firm. I cannot abandon my friend. He is my friend. He is with me from the beginning till end. All my brothers have died, but this is keeping company with me. I cannot come without my friend. To betray him, it would be a great sin. But Indra didn't let him do this. He tried to persuade him. No, you have already renounced everything. Your brother's wife, everybody. You were a great king, you have left everything, you have left. Why you are having attachment to this small mere dog? This useless dog you are attaching yourself too much. You come, he said. Yudhishthira replied, the same voice. My brothers and Draupadi were dead. And I could not bring them back to life. But this dog, he is alive. He is not dead. He has been my companion. I will not abandon him for my happiness, he said. At that moment, the dog transformed into a deity, Dharma, the god of righteousness and Yudhishthira's father, Yamadharma. This dog, which turned into Yamadharma, smiled at Yudhishthira and praised him, saying, you have passed the final test, my son. You have upheld the highest form of dharma, showing loyalty, compassion, righteousness, all the things you have shown. You are indeed worthy of heaven, he said. With this, praise to Yudhishthira, he accompanied my dharma, that is Yamadharma, ascended to heaven in the Indra's chariot. They climbed in the Indra's chariot. They went there. Along the way, they were greeted by a lot of people like sage Narada, who praised Yudhishthira for achieving what no other mortal had achieved in this world. Entering heavens in his human body is impossible. All these praises were given to him. So now with this body, he went there. And he saw all his brothers, everybody, they were sitting there. He just lived happily there in the heaven. So, Yudhishthira, the eldest of Pandava, known for his unwavering adherence to Dharma, completed his journey. This story remains a timeless lesson in virtue, humility, and the ultimate path to liberation. This is what the story tells us. So, viewers, with this small story of Yudhishthira or Dharmaraya going to heaven, we conclude this episode. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.